Thank you so much, Amanda, for the beautiful and powerful readings tonight. Tonight, I'd like to express my gratitude for citation in the lesson this week. It says, to ascertain our progress, we must learn where our affections are placed and whom we acknowledge and obey as God. If divine love is becoming nearer, dearer, and more real to us, matter is then submitting to spirit. The objects we pursue and the spirit we manifest reveal our standpoint and show what we are winning. This instruction has been very, very, very helpful because for a long time, I would always check a claim to see if it's changing and to determine my progress by that. Later, I found out that is not the right way, since to understand what God is and to know that that is what I am, that expression of and manifestation of is what proves my progress. That is why the instruction to turn from the false testimony, seek God, what he is, and identify with that, and obey him as all in all. Doing this consistently does make clearer for us what we are, and in that clearer picture of our true being, we find no sign of the false claim. The more God is becoming all in all, the more every negative is becoming nothing. I am so grateful for this understanding because without Christian Science, first, I would always keep accepting and making real the false suggestions and come and then keep checking it. Is the claim gone? Is it improved? While doing that, making God less and less. If God is love, and he is, as we read in the Bible so many times in Science and Health, how can we find and understand this great love and at the same time find pain, bitterness, sin, anger, resentment, sorrow, regret, and any other negative in him? Thank God for Christ Jesus, showing us that our Father, Mother God, is all, that he is love, and Mrs. Eddy for explaining and emphasizing how important it is to obey that truth. For everyone's testimony, for the hymns, I'm just grateful to be here tonight.